Arch, this is Ryan with TrendLizard.com. Very happy to be doing these videos for you. You've been a subscriber at TrendLizard.com for a very long time, and it's been an absolute pleasure communicating with you over the years. So very glad to see you've become a professional level subscriber so that I can do these videos for you. Now, you sent me an email asking for analysis on Tesla, GBTC, which is the Bitcoin trust that we trade at TrendLizard.com, and then also ROM, which is a 2x technology ETF, all very interesting and all very worthy of this effort to analyze them and see what the future holds. So we're going to get to it. We got a ton to look at, Arch. Again, just a pleasure to be doing this for you, but let's dive in. So we're going to start with Tesla. We actually analyzed Tesla fairly recently on our YouTube channel, but I want to take another look for you. It's been an absolute beast, obviously, off the 2019 low, but we'll get to that. So it was incepted back in 2010. Looks like one large five-wave advance. It has basically two modes. That's very sideways, choppy moves, or very large, spiky, trendy up moves. So those are both bullish things, counter trend pullbacks or trendy up moves. Once it completed what appears to be a five-wave move in the 2017 high, it underwent a large three-wave pullback. It doesn't look that large in the context of this chart here, which is a log scale, but it did almost retrace 61.8% retracement of this 61.8% of this entire advance off that 2010 low. So very confident that this was a larger counter trend pullback that corrected all of this move from 2010 into the 2017 low. The reason I say that is it means that this move that started in 2019 is a brand new, fresh, beautiful, trendy up move. Obviously, it's part of the uptrend. It has gone to the moon, but it is a brand new move, and that's a bullish thing, and it looks bullish as we will see as we dive in here. So let's go ahead and zoom in on this action off the 2019 low here. This is what we find. This is the low in 2019. There was a nice five-wave advance up into the 2020 high. The coronavirus crash smoked this guy and pulled it back. It actually retraced more than 61.8% at the low. Not surprising. It was a kind of an emotional ordeal, and a lot of things moved quite a bit lower than you would have expected. But it didn't last long for Tesla, and it turned higher from there and has resumed giving us trendy up moves since then. Now, it's kind of bumped its head off of July's high and has been pulling back since then, but this does not look like a completed move. This looks like all part of an ongoing trendy advance that has room to grow. So if we are confident, and I am, that this pullback in 2020 is a second wave, which is how it fits if we take a step back, it looks like a second wave to me. It's by far the biggest move. Then we can say this has a lot of room to grow because we know the trend is up and we know that trends play out in five-wave moves. So both of those things are clear indications that higher prices are coming on Tesla. Let's go ahead and drill in and take a little bit of a closer look at the advance off March's low. You can see that every single up leg that's played out to the upside here has been a beautiful, trendy five-wave advance. And that's obviously a good sign that the trend is up. However, the move is just not complete to the upside, so there is reason to expect additional strength from here. Again, it does appear to be in a fourth wave pullback right now, and this is the key for us. Tesla needs to stay above 1250 to remain bullish. Now, if it starts breaking down below that level, we have to start taking other possible Elliott wave labelings into account. But we don't expect that. What we see here is this pullback already looks like a counter trend move. We expect it to stay above 1250. As long as it does, you could use any weakness here, ideally some weakness that moves below the current low for the pullback but stays above 1250 as an excuse to buy and get prepared for additional strength from here. So that is what Tesla looks like. And there we go. So let's go ahead and move on to ROM. This is the second stock here that you sent to me. I want to start by taking a look at the NASDAQ in general, okay? So what has happened on the NASDAQ is it's been up about 66% off of March's low. It's a very big up move that's taken place already, okay? So now we're going to compare that to what's taken place in one of the most bullish periods in stock market history, which was back in the late 1990s, the dot-com bubble. And let's take a look at what happened to the NASDAQ during that time. You can see there were some very strong up moves over that period, very straight, direct moves. The four most direct moves that took place over the entire dot-com bubble moved these percentages, okay? 51% advance, 46% advance, 86% advance, and a 59% advance without pulling back. Now, the current advance on the NASDAQ is, again, 66%. So that is a massive move that's taken place. And it has to make you wonder if the upside is limited from here. Now, I don't want to claim that anything is over until there's clear proof that it's over. I'm just saying, I'm not sure that it's a very opportune time to be looking to buy a leveraged technology ETF at the end of a 66% run, one of the biggest moves in the NASDAQ's history. That said, let's go ahead and dive in on ROM and take a closer look. And this is why I send that warning. Basically, everything that's happened on ROM has been in the context of the bull market that began in 2009. You can see that it's a very strong bullish five-wave move, but at the end of the day, it looks like it's nearing the end of a five-wave move. Now, wave five here may go on for quite a bit longer and may become an even larger five-wave move. That's a possibility, but from where I stand at the end of a 66% move in complete uncertainty in an economic and financial standpoint, I'm a little bit hesitant to recommend buying a stock that looks like it's at the end of a large five-wave move. Now, a lot of other things appear to have completed their bull markets and are in a larger countertrend pullback, things of that nature. It's a much more difficult proposition to say that the bull market ended on the NASDAQ when it has already moved back to new long-term highs. It looks more like a five-wave advance. So that is the concern there. Let's dive in a little bit closer on ROM to get some more details here. This is a closer look at that pullback off the 2018 high, and it shows a little bit more detail as to why we think a fifth wave advance is starting now and didn't complete in early 2020. The main reason is the advance in 2019 is a very clear three-wave move, and what we know about three-wave moves, as you know from years of being with me at TrendLizard.com, those are counter-trend moves. So that three-wave move to the upside in 2019 and the beginning of 2020 looks like just a big B-wave within a fourth wave down that began back in 2018. So there's your fourth wave down, and that gives way to a very strong, very direct, trendy move that has moved to new long-term highs. So let's go ahead and look a little bit closer at this move to show you what's important about ROM moving forward. So here is a look at the advance off of March's low. This too looks like a trendy five-wave move that should be nearing an end. I mean, I can't say for certain. It's been such a strong and direct move. The pullbacks have been very small and basically haven't stuck around for very long. So it's hard for me to look at this labeling and say I'm 100% confident that it's at the very end of its move. But again, this move is so big. It's one of the biggest moves that's ever happened on the NASDAQ. And it just doesn't look like a buying opportunity to me at this point in time. I could be wrong. You could get an extended fifth wave up, and I could feel pretty stupid about how far this thing runs without me being involved. But it's so extended already. It looks like a five-wave move. It's happening at a point where we could be at the fifth, you know, near the end of the entire 2009 advance on technology. I don't think it is. I don't think we're moving in on this major high, but it's enough to give me pause to want to say I need to see a larger counter trend pullback take place on this stock before I'm buying it or anything that's associated with it. QQQ, whatever the case may be. If you have some near-term positions, more power to you. Write them out. That's okay. But you reached out to me saying that you wanted to look for some more long-term established type positions. I just wouldn't be buying right here. What I would do is wait for a larger pullback. A move below 200 at any point would be a good indication that this up leg is ended and we're getting a larger pullback. And look for something larger to the downside to suggest that this big up leg off of the 2020 low is being corrected. Now, if that pullback proves to be a counter trend move, there's your buying opportunity. That's when you start diving in and get involved. I just wouldn't do it before everything is so extended and there's a possibility that a major high is looming, and I just want proof that it's not. You know, that's I would want to see that before I get involved with ROM. So I hope that's helpful. Again, my base case is that it's nearing a high. A move below 200 at any point would confirm that. Wait for a larger counter trend pullback, at which point you can become a buyer from there. in anticipation of the next five-wave advance. All right, so we got one more for you. Let's go ahead and take a look at GBTC, which is the Bitcoin Trust, basically the Bitcoin ETF that we track every day at TrendLizard.com. So this is one that I've analyzed before in video form. We'll do it again. I am bullish on Bitcoin. I'm bullish on GBTC overall, and here is why. It was incepted back in 2015. It underwent a very large five-wave advance up into the 2017 high. Beautiful move. It pulled back a ton, but then has been kind of in this recovery effort type thing that's been taking place since late 2018. Now, the big takeaway that I get right away from this pullback off of the 2017 high is that it's a counter trend three-wave move. That's a bullish thing, and it indicates to me that the overall trend is still up. The question we have to ask ourselves is the trend resuming here off the 2018 low? Is that the start of what's going to be a much larger five-wave advance to new highs and beyond? Or are we still in a larger counter trend pullback? And that's what we need to dive in closer to find out. So here's a look at what I think is the most likely scenario, and that is that it is still in a larger counter trend pullback. The main reason why I believe that to be the case is because of the depth of this pullback off of the 2019 high. This retraced substantially more than 61.8% of this up leg that kicked off the recovery back off of the 2018 low. So while the overall move does look like a counter trend affair to the downside, it still looks like a move that's probably not complete. That said, it doesn't mean it's a bad opportunity at the moment. Here is what we're expecting to happen on GBTC. We expect an up move above the 2019 high as this B wave recovery completes. If the current up leg is to be the same size as this up leg in early 2019, it'll get up to 1880 before it completes. Currently, it's trading at around $13, a $5 move. That's pretty substantial, probably worth your time unless you have a very long-term outlook. Once you get that up leg, if you get any kind of resistance or any kind of reversal from there, then we would conclude that we are indeed going to get a C wave down to complete this large counter trend pullback before the overall trend resumes. So that is what we think will play out overall. But I think in the near term and the midterm, you should see continued strength as it works its way higher up to the 1880 area, which is a very good opportunity from there. So here's a little bit closer look at that advance off the 2019 low. It shows you that it's retraced, that this pullback retraced substantially more than 61.8%. But it does look trendy and bullish in the respect that up legs take on five-wave forms, and this pullback is a clear three-wave move. So again, on the midterm time frame, things look great. We expect it to head up to the 1850 to 19 area, and it's going to look immediately bullish as long as it's trading above 11. If it moves below 11 at any point in time, you'd have to expect that this up leg in 2020 is over, and that it's going to be corrected to the downside before strength continues from there. So either way, I think you need to be bullish on Bitcoin in the near and midterm until it makes its way back up to that 1850, 19 area or so. Once it completes that move, we need to be on guard for a reversal down. But in the meantime, it looks like a great buying opportunity. So there it is, Arch. I hope that's helpful to you. Obviously, you can follow up with me via email with any questions you have about any of this stuff. And again, it's been a pleasure. Have a great weekend, and we will talk to you again very soon. Take care.